dear friends, I am Dr. K. Kannan, Professor of Mechanical Engineering, Anjali Ammal Mahalingam Engineering College, Koyilvanni. I am happy to meet you again on the video lecture on the topic steam nozzle. This is problem number 5. So earlier we discussed the steam nozzle theory, and we solved a few problems in the 4 parts of the problem. This is the 5th part of the problem. We solved the question paper from the recent Anna University question paper. And these are all the books I have published earlier in the mechanical engineering subject. Design of transmission system, turbo machines, heat and mass transfer, operations research, gas dynamics and jet propulsion, thermal engineering, fluid mechanics and machinery. And I have a YouTube channel where I have published the video lecture on the subjects mentioned here, and also I am uploading the video lectures on the gate solution, the solution for the gate question paper in mechanical engineering subject. You please subscribe this channel so that you will listen to the various video lectures and the gate solutions. And this is example number 1 from the November 2018, November 2009 and November 2012 question paper. In a steam nozzle, the steam expanded from 4 bar to 1 bar. The initial velocity is 60 meters per second and the initial temperature is 20 degrees Celsius. Determine the exit velocity if the nozzle efficiency is 92%. So we write down the given data. So pressure P1 equal to 4 bar, temperature T1 equal to 200 degrees Celsius, pressure P2 equal to 1 bar, and V1 velocity at inlet equal to 60 meters per second, and nozzle efficiency is 0.92. And we have to refer to the table, steam table, for solving the problem. We have to take the steam properties from the steam table. So this is the extract of this steam table. We have to take the properties of enthalpy of superheated steam, specific enthalpy of the superheated steam for 4 bar and 200 degrees Celsius. So from this table, we can take 4 bar and 200 degrees Celsius, 2860.4 kilojoules per kilogram. Similarly, the specific entropy of superheated steam, this is again for 4 bar, 200 degrees Celsius, 7.171 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin. So you have your steam table side by side so that you can verify the data to solve the problem. Then from the steam table P2, exit pressure is 1 bar. Again, this is table number 2 from the steam table. So we have to take the saturated water and steam pressure table. So from page number 9, we have the property for data for 1 bar. So we write down H of 2, 417.5, H of G2, 2257.9, S of 2, 1.303, and S of G2, 6.057 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin. Now we have to calculate the quality of the steam at the outlet. For isentropic flow in the nozzle, S1 equal to S2. So S1 equal to for superheated steam, and S2 equal to, we assume it is wet steam. So S of 2 plus X2 into S of G2. So substituting, S1 equal to 7.171, S of 2 from here 1.303 plus X2 into 6.057. So solving this equation, X2 equal to 0.97. Once you have X2, we calculate the enthalpy of the steam at outlet. H2 equal to H of 2 plus X2 into H of G2. So H2 equal to 417.5 plus 0.97 into 2257.9 equal to 2607.6 kilojoules per kilogram. Now the velocity of the steam at the exit, so V2 equal to square root of 2 into H1 minus H2 into nozzle efficiency plus V1 square. So we substitute 2 into H1 equal to, so we have taken 2860.4, H2 equal to 2607.6 we have calculated, and these two values, it is in kilojoules per kilogram. We have to substitute in joules per kilogram, so multiply by 1000 into nozzle efficiency is 0.92 plus 60 square inlet velocity 60 square. So solving this equation, the exit velocity of the steam is 684.65 meters per second. So we have to calculate the only question is we have to determine the exit velocity. So exit velocity is 684.65 meters per second. Example number 2 from November 2013 question paper. Steam expands isentropically in a nozzle from 1 megapascal 250 degrees Celsius to 10 kilopascal. The flow rate of the steam is 1 kilograms per second. Find the following when the inlet velocity is neglected. 1. Quality of the steam. 2. Velocity of the steam at the exit of the nozzle. And 3. Exit area of the nozzle. So we write down the given data. So given data P1 equal to 1 megapascal equal to 10 bar. T1 equal to 250 degrees Celsius, P2 equal to 10 kilopascal equal to 0.1 bar and the mass of the steam equal to 1 kilogram per second. Now from the steam table, so once again it is superheated steam. The enthalpy of superheated steam at 10 bar 250 degrees Celsius. So 10 bar, so enthalpy of superheated steam 10 bar 250 degrees Celsius 2943 kilojoules per kilogram. And the specific entropy, again 10 bar 250 Celsius, 6.926 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin. So these two tables we have to take, page number 19 and page number 22. Then from the steam table at the 0.1 bar, P2 equal to 0.1 bar. So this is the extract of the table. Absolute pressure, we have the specific volume, specific enthalpy and specific entropy, 1 bar. So we have to take HF2. 191.8, HFG2 2392.9 kilojoules per kilogram, SF2 0.649, SFG2 7.502 and VG2 14.675 meter cube per kilogram. Now for isentropic flow in the nozzle, we have S1 equal to S2, entropy is constant. So S1 equal to SF2 plus X2 into SFG2. So substituting S1 equal to 6.926 equal to SF2 equal to 0.649. in plus x2 into 7.502. So solving this equation, x2 equal to 0.84. Now we calculate the enthalpy, specific enthalpy, h2 equal to hf2 plus x2 into hfg2, which is 191.8 plus 0.84 into 2392.9 equal to 2201.8 kilojoules per kilogram. And we have to calculate the specific volume, v2 equal to x2 into vg2, which is 0.84 into 14.675 equal to 12.327 meter cube per kilogram. Now the exit velocity of the steam, so V2 equal to 2 into H1 minus H2, so square root of 2 into H1 equal to 2943 minus H2 we have calculated 2201.8, so into 1000 to convert the kilojoules into joules per kilogram. So the substituting and the calculating, the velocity is 1217 meters per second. And the exit area of the nozzle, A2 equal to, from the continuity equation, A2 equal to M specific volume V2 divided by velocity V2. So M small V2 by capital V2, small V2 is the specific volume, capital V2 is the velocity. So 1 into 12.327 divided by 1217.5 equal to 0.01 meter square. The area of the nozzle at the exit equal to 0.01 meter square. So we have calculated. So the quality is 0.84. Velocity is 1217.5 meters per second. And the area equal to 0.01 meter square. We take example number 3 from November 2013 question paper. Dry saturated steam enters a steam nozzle at a pressure of 15 bar and is discharged at a pressure of 2 bar. If the drainage fraction of this discharge steam is 0.96, what will be the final velocity of the steam? Neglect the initial velocity of the steam. If 10% heat drop is lost in friction, find the percentage reduction in the final velocity. So the given data. So P1 equal to 15 bar and dry saturated steam, P2 equal to 2 bar, X2 quality at the exit 0.96 and nozzle efficiency is 90%. So 10% heat drop, that gives nozzle efficiency 90%, 0.9. So from steam table for 15 bar, so it is dry saturated steam, So we have to take the saturated table. So for 15 bar, H1 equal to HG1, which is equal to 2789.9 kilojoules per kilogram. S1 equal to SG1, which is 6.441 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin. And from the steam table, P2 equal to 2 bar. So we have to take from the table, again pressure table, table number 2. So for 2 bar, HFT equal to 504.7 and HFGT equal to 2201.6. So we have to calculate the enthalpy H2 equal to HF2 plus X2 into HFG2, which is 504.7 plus 0.96. So the drainage fraction is given in the problem. So 0.96 into 2201.6 equal to 2618.2 kilojoules per kilogram. Now we calculate the velocity of the steam at the exit for isentropic flow. Ideal situation. So V2 equal to square root of 2 into H1 minus H2, which is square root of 2 into 2789.9 minus 2618.2 into 1000, which is 586 meters per second. Velocity of the steam at exit for nozzle efficiency is 90%. So V2 dash equal to 2 into H1 minus H2 into nozzle efficiency, which is 2 into 2789.9 minus 2618.2 into 1000 into the nozzle efficiency, which is calculating this is 555.9 meters per second. Now the percentage reduction in the final velocity, which is V2 minus V2 dash divided by V2 into 100. So 586 minus 555.9 divided by 586 into 100 equal to 5.1%. So the percentage reduction in the velocity equal to 5.1%. That is the answer to the problem. Next example number 4. This is from May 2019 question paper. The inlet condition to a steam nozzle are 10 bar and 250 degree Celsius. The exit pressure is 2 bar. Assuming isentropic expansion and negligible velocity, determine throat area, exit velocity, exit area of the nozzle. So we are given P1 equal to 10 bar, T1 equal to 250 degree Celsius, P3 throat pressure is P3 equal to 2 bar, V1 initial velocity equal to 0. So this is a convergent divergent nozzle. So inlet condition is 1, exit condition is 3, and the throat condition, properties of the throat is designated by 2. Now for the inlet condition, we have to take the properties from the superheated steam table. So for pressure P1 equal to 10 bar and temperature T1 equal to 250 degree Celsius, the specific enthalpy H1 equal to 10 bar, 250 degree Celsius, 2943 kilojoules per kilogram, and similarly specific entropy of the superheated steam, 10 bar, 250 degree Celsius, 6.926 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin. Now this is the convergent divergent nozzle. So throat section, throat pressure we have to calculate using the critical pressure ratio P2 by P1 equal to 2 by n plus 1 to the power n by n minus 1. For superheated steam, n equal to 1.3. The value is not given. So we have to take n equal to 1.3. So P2 equal to 10 into 2 by 1.3 plus 1 to the power 1.3 divided by 1.3 minus 1 equal to 5.46 bar. At the throat section, now the pressure is 5.46 bar. So now for this pressure, we have to take the properties from the steam table. So properties of the steam at 5.46 bar. Before we calculate the properties, we have to calculate the condition of the steam, whether this is wet steam, dry steam or superheated steam. Normally for convergent divergent nozzle, when the inlet condition is superheated steam, in the throat section, it will be in the superheated condition. After that, after the throat only, the condition of the steam will change. So we can comfortably assume that at the throat section, the steam condition is superheated steam. When this is assumed as superheated steam, then the temperature of the superheated steam we have to find out. So to calculate the temperature, the first step, you have to calculate the temperature of the superheated steam, then the properties of the steam here. Now this is the extract of the steam table, so pressure table. So we have 5.2, 5.4, 5.6, but our given pressure, calculated pressure is 5.46 bar. Now, for 5.46, we have to take all the properties by interpolation. So, I have taken pressure 5.4 bar, 5.6 bar. We are taking the HG2, SG2, TS2, VG2. So, from the steam table, you write down the data. So, 5.4, we write down 5.4 HG1 equal to 2750.9. 5.6, it is 2752.5. And SG2, so 6.793 and 5.6, it is 6.781. Similarly, TS2 and TSVG2, we write from the table for 5.4 and 5.6. We designate 5.4 as Y1 and 5.6 as Y2. Now, we have to calculate Y. So, we take this formula. Y equal to Y1 plus Y2 minus Y1 divided by 10 into 3. So, we have to calculate 5.46. So, we have 5.4 plus some fraction. So, the Y1 equal to 5.4, some fraction is 0.06. How to get 0.06? 5.6 minus 5.4, listen here, 5.6 minus 5.4 divided by 10. So, 5.6 minus 5.4 equal to 0.2 divided by 10 equal to 0.02 into 3 equal to 0.06. So, 5.4 plus 0.06 equal to 5.46. Similarly, for enthalpy, so we calculate for enthalpy 27, the same logic we follow, 5.4, the corresponding enthalpy is 2750.9, 5.6, the enthalpy is 2752.5 minus 2750.9 divided by 10 into 3 equal to 2751.38. So, HGT equal to 2751.38. Similarly, SG2 equal to 6.7894. We calculate TS2 equal to 155.2 and VG2 equal to 0.3449. So, this is what called as linear interpolation. When the data is not available, so when we have to interpolate, sometimes we have to interpolate. So, this is the procedure for interpolation. For isentropic flow, S1 equal to S2. So, S1 equal to S2 equal to SG2 plus Cp into logarithmic of T2 by TS2. We substitute all the values, 6.926 equal to 6.7894 plus 2.2. We take the specific heat of the steam as 2.2 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin. It is logarithmic of T2 by 155.2 plus 273. So, the logarithmic of T2 by 428.22 equal to 6.926 minus 6.7894 divided by 2.2 equal to 0.062. So, you take the exponential. So, T2 by 428.22 equal to e to the power of 0.062 equal to 1.06. So, T2 equal to 453.9 Kelvin or 180.9 degree Celsius. Then we calculate the enthalpy, H2 equal to HG2 plus Cp into T2 minus TS2, which is 2751.38 plus 2.2 into 180.9 minus 152.22 equal to 2807.876 kilojoules per kilogram. So, this is the enthalpy at the throat section. Now, we calculate the specific volume at the throat section, V2 equal to VG2 into T2 by TS2. Which is 0.3449 into 453.9 in Kelvin, temperature in Kelvin, divided by 428.22 equal to 0.3656 meter cube per kilogram. Now, velocity and area at the throat section. So, V2 equal to square root of 2 into H1 minus H2, which is square root of 2 into 2942 minus 2807.876 into 1000, which is 517.9 meters per second. And the area equal to, from the continuity equation, m into small v2 divided by capital V2, specific volume divided by the velocity, which is 1 into mass flow rate is not given. We assume 1 kilograms per second. So, 1 into 0.3656 divided by 517.9 equal to 7.06 in 10 power minus 4 meter square. Now, from the steam table, at the exit condition of the steam nozzle, convergent divergent nozzle, P3 equal to 2 bar. Now, we take the properties from the pressure table. For 2 bar, we note down the properties. HF1 equal to 504.7, HFG2 equal to 201.6, SF2 equal to 1.53 and SFG3 equal to 5.597. So for isentropic flow, we know S1 equal to S3. So S1 equal to SF3 plus X3 into SFG3. So we have 6.926 equal to S1. SF3 equal to 1.53 plus X3 into 5.597. So solving this equation, X3 equal to 0.96. And now we calculate the enthalpy and the specific volume. Enthalpy H3 equal to HF3 plus X3 into HFG3, which is 504.7 plus 0.96 into 2201.6, which is 2618.23 kilojoules per kilogram. And the specific volume V3 equal to X3 into VG3, which is 0.96 into 0.8854. VG3 equal to 0.8854 equal to 0.85 meter cube per kilogram. Now we calculate the velocity and the area at the exit. V3 equal to square root of 2 into H1 minus H3, which is square root of 2 into 2942 minus 2618.23 into 1000 equal to 804.7 meters per second. And area equal to mass into specific volume divided by the velocity. So 1 into 0.85 divided by 804.7 equal to 1.056 in 10 power minus 3 meter square. So we calculated the velocity, area at the throat section and velocity, area at the exit section. These are all the questions. So we have to calculate, as per the question statement given in the question paper, we have to calculate throat area, exit velocity, exit area at the nozzle. So this is the throat area equal to 7.06 10 power minus 4 meter square, and the exit velocity is 804.7 meters per second, and the exit area equal to 1.056 10 power minus 3 meter square. So thank you for watching. So we will stop here. So you please post your comments on the comments box in the YouTube video. So for it will be useful for improvement. You subscribe the channel, so you can contact me through the mail ID or WhatsApp number for any of your clarification. I will sincerely answer to your queries. So thank you. We will meet again in the next lecture with a few more additional problems.